Okay, now I will show you how to log sensor data into a comma-delimited text file that's saved under the name of SensoDuino.txt in the root of your SD card. Then we're going to basically copy this file to a Windows workstation where we import this text file into Excel. Okay, first let's go and delete any existing log file from the options menu, delete log file, reset counter. This counter is of course useful to track any missing data, and if you see any missing numbers in this sequential tally, that's a sign that some data is missing. Okay, now let's just enable 1, 2, 3. Let's just enable 3 sensors: orientation, gravity, and rotation. And now let's check the log checkbox. Now data is being logged at a rate of, I would say, 2 readings per second. 2 readings per second. I can speed this up or slow it down, but this is fine for our purposes. Okay, we've captured enough data, so I'm just going to exit SensoDuino. And now, if I go to my file with the file manager, SD card 0, there you have it. This is the comma delimited text file in all its glory. Okay, now I have my Android device connected to my PC. So now I'm just going to open my Windows Explorer, and since my Samsung device is connected via USB, I'll just open up the SD card, and there you have it. So if I open it up, that's the data. Doesn't look pretty. Let me copy it. And I'm going to just dump it here in the root directory of D. And I'm going to run Excel. I'm going to say file, open D. I'm going to select all files, SensoDuino, open. And I'm going to say it's delimited. That's fine. Next, it's comma delimited. And here, I get the data neatly placed in columns. And then I'm going to say next. And here, I'll decide if I want to make additional changes. This is the sensor name, this is the log counter, this is X, Y, Z, and an accuracy designation. Looks good. There you have it. Orientation, orientation, gravity, orientation, rotation vector, 61, 64, 65, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73. 74, 75, so at the beginning, that's because I was turning on sensors without actually logging their data. The counter was still running, and here you have the accuracy indicator. You have to reference the Android SDK for meanings for those numbers. Now you can do all sorts of analysis on this data.